The interim result of the phase 3 clinical trials of Russia's Sputnik vaccine has been published on the medical journal The Lancet. Based on studies, the vaccine is seen as safe and effective. Russian Direct Investment Fund CEO Kirill Dmitriev says it has a high efficacy rate. RDIF supports the development of Russia's COVID-19 vaccine by the Gamaleya Center, the maker of Sputnik V.
1.6%.
91.6.
People over 60 years old, it's actually slightly higher. It's 91.8%. And what's also important, 100% protection against severe cases of COVID. And also no allergies, no anaphylactic shock that we see in some other vaccines, and very good safety profile. So 94% of all of the side effects were really minor.
Dmitriev adds clinical trials for the vaccine have been conducted in various countries, including the UAE, Belarus, Venezuela, and India. This week, 12 more countries are set to begin their own inoculation using Russia's vaccine, on top of the 16 countries already using it. Gamaleya Institute will not hold trials for Sputnik V in the Philippines, but they are in negotiations with the government for the possible use of the vaccine in the country.
We are working very close with your regulator. You have a very diligent and very professional regulator. We have sent them all of the information, and that information was enough to approve Sputnik in 16 countries.
The Philippine Health Department welcomes the finding, but Sputnik still needs to go through the regulatory process, similar to what Pfizer and AstraZeneca went through, the only two manufacturers who have been given emergency use authorization by the Food and Drug Administration. Health Secretary Francisco Duque says manufacturers continue to study the effects of new variants on cases.
Just as the variants are getting either smarter and the possibility of them evading the vaccines are very high.
Meanwhile, the European Union says the Philippines will not be affected should it push through with its vaccine export ban. The EU says it will still provide vaccines to nearly 100 low- and middle-income countries under the World Health Organization's COVAX facility. The EU says it remains fully committed to the global fight against the pandemic. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.